In this video, we are going to learn how to use this M5 stack Core 2 ESP32 development module with VL53L0X laser distance sensor to measure distance and display it on a screen, either a centimeter or switch it to millimeter. Put it around 3. I've also implemented here the power off with this push button. When you touch it, it says it will be shut down and turn it on with power. Hi, welcome to ESP32 tutorial from RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. You can get the data sheet and other files related to this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. A separate video explaining this module fully. The link for that is below the video in the description. A separate video explaining this VL53L0X. We're going to use it with this M5 stack Core 2 ESP32 module. This has VCC ground, SCL and SDA. SCL is the clock, SDA is the data pin. We're using it with this module. And the feature that I've implemented is that we will measure the distance in centimeter or millimeter and select it with these two touch buttons. And also the third one, I use it for power. So when you touch it, the device will shut down in 3 seconds and will tell you that power button to turn it on. And here is the wiring for this. I used only 4 wires. Do not worry about this. This is extra wire that I have not used it in this tutorial. We have VCC. VCC have been connected here on the second wire on the right side. It has been labeled clearly. The first one is battery. So this is for the row on this side, and this column is for the column on the right side. So this is on the second pin, this orange. And then we have ground. Ground is connected to one of these 3 grounds on the left side, first, second, and third on the left side is ground. And then we have SCL and SDA have been connected here using this blue and green wire to the sixth row. And if you see here, G32 and G33, these are SDA and SCL. These are for external, for devices that you use, because we have also SDA and SCL for internal. And this is, if you count it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's the sixth one, and I've connected them at sixth one if you count. The right side, this is SCL, green is connected to SCL on the right side, and this blue is SDA, and SDA have been connected on the left side, on the sixth row. First, we have to install the driver for M5 Core 2. Click on File, Preferences, and in this area, click here, provide you the link. This is the link. Paste it here. If you have other stuff, just go to the last line and press Enter and paste it here. Once you're done, click OK and click OK. This will tell the system where to get the drivers. By clicking at Tools, Board Manager, Boards, and then Board Manager. Wait for this bar graph to complete. This area, type M5 stack, and here M5 stack, and install it. Mine shows remove. For you, it will be installed. Once you're done, then click close. After that, install libraries by clicking at Tools, Manage Libraries. Wait for this to complete. Type M5 Core 2. And here you will see M5 Core 2. It says installed. In your case, you will see install button and install it. After that, we need to install the VL53L0X library from Pololo. Again, go to Tools, Manage Libraries. And then type VL53L0X after this bar graph completes and stops. VL53L0X. So you will see this, scroll down until you see VL53L0X by Palolo and install it. Wait for the bar graph to complete and close it. Make sure to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos. So this was part of the library for M5 Core 2. This is wire for I2C communication. This is for the VL53L0X time of flight sensor library, which we just installed. From the class of library, we create an instance. We call it sensor. And these are the variables that I have defined. Maximum distance, this is not used, but it can be used, so you can ignore certain distances. 800, that's for millimeter. And then the type here, we define 1 for millimeter, 2 for centimeter, and 3 for inch. So type the type that you want, 1, 2, or 3. And these are the text that is displayed on the screen here, this centimeter, and if I press it, millimeter. These are coming from here. So if you want to change it to something else, but keep the quotation, put whatever you want inside it. And these are two variables, centimeter and inch, are being stored in this variable, in this float type. So they're being used, and distance is the millimeter in terms of unsigned integer. This is a prototype which is at the bottom of the code, which I'm going to explain it later. Inside the setup, M5 begin is initializing the module. This is creating a full screen black with black background, and this is setting set color for the text yellow, and then this is setting the text size 5, and then wire.begin is for I2C communication. This is just printing the text on the screen. This is just setting the baud rate for the screen so we can read. This line sensor.initiate, this is initializing the sensor. This is setting the timeout. If there is some issue within 500 milliseconds, it will time out. And this is sensor start continuous, is initializing the continuous sensor reading, and we wait for 1 second, and setup is ending here. Inside the loop, every time it goes, we have to create a clear the screen, and that's why we are filling up the screen with black, setting cursor at 0, 0, x0 and y0, and printing this word called distance, this text, sensor.read continuous millimeter, and the result of this is stored in this variable called distance, which is at the top of the code. So this will hold it in millimeter. Now we check if the type is equal 3, then it means it is inch. So we set the cursor at 0, 60. Before, for the text was at 0, 0, and this is at 0, 60. The reason for that is this is a 60 pixel from the top. If you count it, it comes at this point. So we set it, and then we get the distance multiplied by this value, convert it to float, and this will give us inch. So we call it distance IN, inch, which is at the top of the code. This will hold an inch, the value, and then here we get that inch value, and here we are formatting it with 4 decimal places of type float. This means the type is float, and we want 4 decimal places an inch. So this use printf. Pay attention, this is just print, and this is printf. When you have f, then you can do here formatting for the value. And here at the end, we print unit type, whatever is the type. If it is 3, 3 minus 1 would be 2. It goes, gets the millimeter, inch, or centimeter, and prints it at the end. If it is number 2, then we divide it by 10, which makes a centimeter, store it in here. And again, because we have only 1 decimal place, formatting it using printf. So centimeter is here. This line will print it, and this line, this was again type minus 1, type minus 1. So this is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. It gets the value, which is centimeter, and we'll print it. Else mean it is type 1 and it is centimeter. Again, we go to 60 pixel 60 at y direction, and we print the distance. It is millimeter. We don't need any conversion, and we print the unit at the end. And then we wait 500 milliseconds. This function is in here, and it prints the text on the serial monitor. If you click here or go to tools, serial monitor, so you can see it. But if you uncomment this, it will print. Otherwise, you don't need to do it. So this is for debugging, if in case it doesn't show on the screen and you want to see it. And this one, again, it prints on the serial monitor the distance, and the type is 3. It gets the distance in inch. If the type is 2, it prints a centimeter. Else, it prints the actual distance, which is in millimeter. And at the end, it prints the unit, and we create a new line. So this was the full explanation of the code. Make sure to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos. And here is a demonstration of measuring distance in millimeter. I'm putting it at around 60 in here. So we should get 60 millimeter, 90 millimeters, or let's go 20 millimeters, if I'm putting it properly. And here's a test for centimeter. I'm putting it around 5. At around 6 centimeter, I'm going 10. Now I'm at 17. Let's go 3. So it responds very well. And here is a test in inch unit. Let me put it at around 3. As you can see, we are reading 4. Let me go 7. One inch. So, perfectly responding. Now, this is the code where we use push button to select millimeter or centimeter. I've explained the above. Everything is the same, except in here. We check fm5.pushbuttona. So pushbutton A is on the left side. This is A, this is B, and this is C. If it is pressed, then this value will be true. We say F, this is true, then the type is 2. F button B is true, then the type is 1. If button C is pressed, so that this is now, we do not do the type. We set the cursor at 0, 0, set the text size, and we print this, make the screen black, and we print shutting down, and then we are changing the text and creating a new line, and then we say use power and then backslash in mean go new line. Power switch 2 and then backslash n again, it goes to turn it on, it goes to the next line, and we wait 3 seconds, and then after that we use M5 shutdown. So this will shut down the device if you press the button C. And then here the rest is exactly the same. We read the distance, we do the conversion, which I explained it in the previous code. And the rest of the code is exactly the same as before. The power off with this push button, when you touch it, it says it will be shut down, and turn it on with power. Thank you for watching a tutorial on ESP32. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it in the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so now. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how we can send the stepper motor from the interface of your phone or mobile device or a browser to any predetermined angles by simple touch. It will be controlled over Wi-Fi and you will have unlimited number of push buttons. Each will have their own angle, direction, and speed.